I miss sports, and I didn't realize how much I miss sports, man.
Yeah, until it's gone, it's like, yo, like, I'm used to getting home from work and checking the schedule for the day, what's game on watch. Like, they ain't watching.
I mean, outside of getting the notifications from Bleacher Report and looking at scores, man.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I go in, I'm like, oh, okay. Transactions, mad transactions happening in the NFL. That's cool.
Yeah, the NFL, they've been working. They've been moving.
Yeah.
Tom Brady to the Buccaneers.
Your 49ers traded
DeForest Buckner.
DeForest Buckner.
We freed up some cap space. We re-signed Arik Armstead.
Nick Foles went to the Bears.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who?
So, Nick Foles.
Yeah, exactly. Who?
Yeah. Nick Foles went to the Bears.
And so Trubisky's a backup now?
Well, they said they're gonna play for the starting position.
You know how bad you have to be to have those two? Graham is gonna be your new starting tight end?
Mariota went to the Raiders.
Yeah.
Because Mariota and Carr are still there.
Yeah.
So.
Mariota. How the fuck did Ryan Tannehill get 100 and $888?
And they franchise Henry.
Bro.
Last year, I guess that was enough for what they saw to throw the bread
out. All was game manage. Derrick Henry deserves that check for him.
Yeah, they franchise tagged him.
But you get to save some money. Like, yo, we could do that. Yeah, after you do that next year.
Mm-hmm.
When all you do is throw for 107 yards, you get $62 million guaranteed.
Yeah.
That's
the NFL. That's the NFL. That's what I'll be telling people thought they just started doing some of that kind of tricky stuff. Nah, they've been like this. That's the NFL. If you was boycotting before, might as well keep boycotting because they ain't changed.
The CBA allowed players say this shit is trash.
Yeah, they added another game, added another playoff game, but they said, hey, you guys can smoke weed. Sign it.
Word.
Deal. <Thank you. laughs> It was like, deal. They're like, but y'all don't make no more money. No, cool. We can play another game. That's cool.
I just wanted to smoke.
Word.
It was like, we got to play one more game. Okay. It was like, what'd he say? I didn't hear nothing after that. Like, I don't know what he said. All I heard was they ain't testing us.
Word,
that's all they care about. It was like, we're not testing you. Okay, cool. And we're also, no, say no more. Say no more.
You stand for something or fall for anything, man.
Exactly. Somebody, you can imagine the players, president, whatever, was in the meeting, had a bag of something right there, like, word? Y'all not testing us?
Like, all right, rolled up right there.
So what you're saying is we ain't got to.
So what I'm saying is,
man was like, word up. They was like, oh, for real?
Oh, that shit is, I mean, but it's like anything else that's union related. They always leave a lot on the table. Anything has I love unions because they do protect workers at times, but at the same time, when it comes to contract negotiations, man, they leave a lot on tables.
And this is a 10-year deal. This is a 10-year deal. I think they said they usually do 5 years. This is a 10-year deal. They capped that 17th game, so nobody can make over, what was it, $250K for that game or something like that. So even when they do get new contracts and they get but that game can't exceed a certain amount, so that's going to cap off your contract, basically. So they fell for that. It's an extra game, and then it's an extra wild card team.
Yeah.
So now it used to be one and two got the bye. Now only the one seeds get the bye. So now you're the second seed. You got to play an extra game. Wild card. Yep. So a lot more teams are playing two games now. Like it's crazy.
I don't know.
But they're not getting tested for weed, so everybody happy. Let's play ball.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody should. Is you know what I'm saying? It's just the NFLPA is the weakest union of all the major sports, and we've already knew that. We all knew that already, and it just showed it again. They didn't get anything. The biggest thing that they won was this. Now, no weed testing. Before that, it was no 2-a-days. And it's like, yo, you're asking for the littlest things. You're asking for the simplest thing. Oh, we don't want to work out twice a day. Like, okay, deal. Yeah, like, we want to get truck desert. Okay, deal. Like, they're not bending the owner's backs. Yeah. Like, they're not getting nothing major.
Yeah.
And every year, they get less and less. And it's like, yeah, y'all still don't make a lot of money off of the TV deals.
The TV deals.
Yeah, the TV deals. Like, the NFL is the most profitable of the four major sports. The
player likenesses.
Yeah, they're the most profitable in the least amount of time because Sunday's the day. Like, everybody's watching on Sunday. Super Bowl is always the highest rated TV show. So they generate, I forgot the exact number, almost $2 billion or something like that per year, easy. And the players don't see much of that. Like, they still in the millions of that. And it's like, but y'all not asking for it. So
you don't give fully guaranteed contracts. That should be a victory.
Yeah. Dude, they said my Niners could have cut Garoppolo. His guaranteed money was already paid. So even though he got two more years in his contract, we could cut him for free.
Wow.
and he's a quarterback.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, of all the positions, like, dude was a quarterback. And all his guaranteed money was up front. So for the next 2 years or whatever, we can cut him whenever, and it's no hit. So...
Not Drew Rosenhaus.
I don't know who his agent is, but he better call Rock Nation or somebody. Like,
all that money up front and then not know what's gonna happen after the.
Yeah, like he still gets whatever, but the rest of his money is not guaranteed. It's still just if he's still here. I think he got like if he signs if he's still there by April, he gets whatever for this year, and then I think it's the same thing again next year. If he's still there, if he's still on the roster by April, then he get. But it's not guaranteed. Like, they can cut him right now.
Exactly.
And it's just like, all right, thank you for making two Super Bowl last year, but you up out of here. We got so and so. So,
right.
It's crazy, and it's wild. But like I said, the players, they don't fight for it. Like, if they don't fight for it, we're not gonna get it.
You gotta think about it. It's like you have a division between the superstars and the lower and talent.
Yeah.
The J.J. Watts, the Aaron Rodgers, the Drew Breeses of the world, they're on a different stratosphere of money than everybody else. So, and people have to try to come together and just have a better means, but they're not.
Doesn't that sound familiar? Sounds like America. Sounds like America.
Especially because you know what? A lot of the players, because there were players who were against playing the extra game.
Yeah.
And most of them were the higher paid players.
Yeah.
And you got to realize, like, yo, like, you taking money out of these dudes' pockets. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is money that they not earning up until this point because they don't even have that game.
Right.
Y'all thinking, hey, I don't play that game. I'm still, but that's y'all. Like, but again, like you said, nobody's, thinking about, hey, if we stand unified, everybody wins.
Because that's what ends up happening. By week 17 now, it's the 16th game, you've clinched already for the most part, if you that dude. So they rest those players. Now we're going to week 18, and by that time, you've already played 16 games. So even if there's a tiebreaker or whatever, like, you kind of know who's in it. So who's playing? So now they're going to sell tickets to a game, and they're banking on it as because the Niners and Seahawks was an epic battle to the last play. So they're hoping that extra week will be more of those.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, teams don't really play. It just so happened that we had the tiebreaker situation, whereas the winner got the first seed, loser dropped the six, and vice versa. So the tension was there, but that doesn't happen every year.
Now, I think preseason also dropped from 4-3, right?
Yeah, because, again, nobody plays. Like, it's like nobody's really in those games to begin with, so we don't need four preseason games. You know what I'm saying? They don't they practice in practice. You don't really see a bunch of reps by the starters in those first couple preseason games. It just doesn't happen. The game is too physical to risk it in a preseason game. You know what I'm saying? So adding this extra game was strictly for it's another home game. And they wanted to do two at first because they wanted to guarantee one home game for everybody. But now it's only one game. So only half the league's gonna get that extra home game, but they're gonna probably alternate it every year.
Every year, right.
You know what I'm saying? But it's the same reason they fly to London, Mexico. It's just to it's for the shield.
For money.
It's for the money. It's not for the teams. It's not, you know what I'm saying? It's no benefit to anybody but the owners and the league itself. It's just an extra ticket sale.
And that's why the owners of the NFL are the biggest pimps.
Mm-hmm.
Because all them hoes are in check.
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
Because they cry at the drop of, like, if they do strike 2 weeks in, they like, I need that money, baby. I got to come back. Yeah,
like, NBA had a whole ass lockout. It was like, fuck y'all.
Baseball killed the whole season. Mm-hmm. And look at them to this day. They still make the most money. They took that. They said, yo, this league is nothing without the players.
Yeah.
And to this day, they got the biggest contract. Yeah. You can't do nothing. Like, it's only a few people. Le'Veon Bell sat out 2 seasons ago. Like, Dak was like, yo, if y'all pay me, I'm sitting. Like, if they all did that, then they would all, you know what I'm saying? But only
they would have a better stance.
Yeah, but they don't.
Le'Veon can't do it by himself. He needs everybody else's help.
And that's what always happens. The top guys that do have the leverage to do it for themselves, but when it comes to collective bargaining time, they don't all just take a stance and say, yo, we're going to strike until we get what we want. They don't do it. And that's in that. We right back in the same place again. And now they stuck with this deal for 10 years.
Yep. In 10 years, when this show's still going on, we're going to look back to this and say, they still getting fucked.
Yep.
With no Vaseline.
Yep. Right. And Kaepernick still won't have a job.
Yeah. he won't be a commentator.
Won't even. Yeah. Romo getting paid, what, more than some players, they said? Like something crazy. He got, what, 10 million? 8 million? Somebody, he got something crazy. Romo got like 10, 12 million.
12, I think.
And he only, like, and even Stephen A was like, I'm on ESPN 24/7. And I ain't even making that. Like, Stephen A do boxing, basketball.
Whatever they tell Stephen A to do.
Like, yo, go there. He like, yes, boss. And he not even making that money. And they was willing to pay.
The PGA got you, boss.
Word. And they was trying to offer Romo way more to bring him in. And he only doing Sunday night football. Or Monday. He was going to do Monday night for them. But he's only doing the Sunday games for CBS. And they paying him 12. ESPN was going to try to double that.
And ESPN, I don't know what's going on ESPN, because they losing a lot of battles, because they try to get Al Michaels to do Monday night football. But NBC rejected on the trade.
I don't know.
They're losing a lot of battles, man. We better get Al Tirico back.
Well, because there's competition now. Before, it was just ESPN. Now, NBC Sports got some leverage. The regular channels got some leverage. You know what I'm saying? Like, so mm-hmm. Fox Sports, you know what I'm saying? There's somewhere to go now. Before, it was like, yeah, I want to be in the major, which is ESPN.
Maybe Ice Cube should have a big three NFL league.
And I feel bad for the XFL, because this was a good year. They played half the season, and it was entertaining. It was fun to watch.
They were doing a good this time.
It really was good. I mean, it wasn't great. You can still see why these guys wasn't in the NFL. Right. There's a lot of drop passes, and you know what I'm saying. But it was a better product. I liked the rule changes. All of the rule changes made sense, and it showed why they did it. And
what was that kid? No, so what was that Keanu Reeves movie, The Replacements?
The Replacements, yeah. Yeah. They a couple of them looked like that. Like, it was a lot of wide open drop passes. But all you can remember is, like, and that's why he's not in the NFL. Got it.
They had some traction. It was going.
It really was. It really was. And I'm sad that some of those guys didn't get to finish. They won't get a championship.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's messed up. Like, they only got halfway through their season, man. It's messed up. But they was – and Vince, too. Like, for Vince, got it right this time. You know what I'm saying? And
tough break, man.
This happens. Yeah, it's messed up. It's messed up.
Shout out to Jameis Winston, man.
Tom Brady got him up out of there.
Tom Brady making as many millions as he threw touchdowns, man.
Yeah. But that's what Tom wanted. He wanted his payday, because he took a lot of pay cuts to get talent.
He wanted his payday, and he wanted actual receivers.
I'm surprised he went to Tampa Bay. I thought they were going to say the Chargers because they had a better defense. They had, like, you know, but when you look at it, the
defense.
But he needs that. He needed the defense because his offense looked a little shaky. But yeah, we'll see him and Mike Evans. We'll see what they can do together.
OJ Howard is
going. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're going to see.
Godwin, a good one.
If the season starts on time, we'll see what happens. Right now, we don't even know. We see where the chess pieces are going. We just don't know when they're going to start playing. But this is already kind of interesting. Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that. Yeah, that's
Tokyo. We might not have Olympics this year.
We might not. We missing out on a lot.
Oh, this shit is real.
2020 is off to a crazy start. We only in March. But that just makes everybody look forward to a 2021 vision.
Stay tuned, visionaries.
You know what I mean? Next year is the year, baby. 2021 is going to be the year where a lot of stuff going to happen.